Transforming loneliness. So the most important thing in transformation is to understand that the shadow states, the lower states, the low frequency states, the painful states, the states of suffering, that they all create the potential for higher opportunities. This is where the journey always begins. It has to begin with the fundamental principle that there is a reason for this state, that this state is not fixed. So for instance, with loneliness, loneliness is a state in which we feel absolutely cut off from everything, from everyone. And it might also be the loneliness that comes from the loss of a deeply loved companion or soul with whom we felt previously very, very connected. So how do we move from that state of ice, isolation, the ice, the frozen life that we find ourselves in, the lifeless state of disconnection, cut off from our source, cut off from the life force itself? And a part of us believes that we're alone in this world. The answer is in our heart. Always the answer is in our heart. Because inside the heart is warmth. And warmth melts ice. So the way to transform loneliness is to go inside your own heart, right here, and to begin to work there, to work inside the atrium of your heart. To begin, you take out the little axe, the ice axe, and you begin to just chip away, ching, 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 every day. So maybe you begin with a prayer or a meditation or a movement, something that begins to focus on opening you here. Perhaps you go and see another person. Perhaps you go and see a therapist. Perhaps you start a yoga class. Perhaps. You do little things that connect you to others, to the world. Because isolation can be a habit, a pattern. You know, it's the mind that has actually frozen first. And so we have to get out, we have to break that habit. And the way to break a habit is with tiny little steps, the tiniest steps. Even one small step, the first step especially, is a great victory. We're going to go into this place here and we're going to begin working. Chip, chip. Chip, 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 chip. And you have to be quite creative in the ways that you do that. But essentially, you're working inside your own being, inside your own body. And there are many paths. And if you ask your own inner heart what to do, it will tell you. It will whisper to you, do this. Call them. Do that. It may not know immediately. But if you keep asking, sooner or later you'll see something somewhere. An idea will come, an invitation. Something will come because you've asked. You've put it out. And when you put it out, from your heart that ache. I no longer wish to feel alone. Please help. Please help. When you send out that ray into the universe has no choice but to answer, and it will answer in some way, and usually fairly soon. And you have to be awake and aware when it comes, the invitation, the first invitation, because many will come, particularly if you take the first one. And I know it's hard. The first baby steps to connect us back to the whole, because that's what's happened. We have to reorient ourselves. We've become dislocated. So we have to reorient ourselves in the universe, which means connecting, which means drawing lines of connection between you and something else. Maybe an animal, maybe a plant, maybe a dog. You can begin with a plant. Get a little plant, put it on your shelf, water it each day, look after it, talk to it, make a connection. You know, then make another connection, maybe get another plant, then maybe another connection with an animal, with a person. You have to step out of your space to connect with the other, because the other is you. The other is a fragment, a fractal, an aspect of your consciousness. So the only way you can reconnect with your heart is in relationship. So you begin with lots of little strings and you connect them up and you start building bridges in the world to experiences, to new things, to new places. You do something you haven't done for a while or ever, and you reach out and you touch something and you keep doing that. And what you're doing is you're connecting your heart to creation. And the more you do that, the more joy you will begin to find. You will find little moments of joy coming to you, little bubbles of joyousness, just little moments, fleeting moments, you know, but they will come more and more, and you will want to do it more and more, and you'll draw more connections and more connections and in different ways. And what you're doing is you're bringing life back into your heart. You know, this ice field. And then the warmth starts to grow and it starts to propagate itself. And then you realize, even if you are alone geographically, physically, you start not to feel alone energetically. You start to feel connected. You can go out under the stars at night or the moon and you can go, wow, I feel connected to the moon. How, I've never felt that before. I feel connected to the stars. The stars are alive. The moon is alive. And so it's not just a lump of dead rock. There's an entity, there's a beingness to it. And those plants are alive and everything is alive. And even those people who we are deeply connected to, who've passed beyond, we mysteriously start to feel their presence as well. We begin to feel them alive. Wow, like something never died, actually. It was, you know, and this is part of the grieving process. It's like we have to move through, we have to let go of that sort of process inside us, that disbelief, and then we start to connect again. And then we begin to feel, wow, everything's alive. Everything's connected. I am it. I am the whole. And then you begin to touch into unity, the unity field, the unified field, where you realize you can never be alone. No one can be alone. It's not possible. It's just a glaze over our perception, because our heart has folded in inside itself and withdrawn. So we have to find the ways to come back gently, gently into unity and open ourselves. And then we find, you know, everything. I mean, everything. It's all available to us. Then we no longer need anything from anyone or ever, because we are it. I am the whole. That's our realization. And we can get there from loneliness. In fact, that is the purpose, the higher purpose of loneliness. Loneliness is an invitation to find unity.